Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate a waffle chart as part of Visuals with Nags series. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So I'm in Power BI now. So what is a waffle chart? Waffle chart is like some kind of similar kind of a distribution like a pie chart and a donut chart. So what it does is like it's used to give a status of different categorical value, right, in terms of percentage. Let's me walk you through this so that you will understand. Let us see the data first. I'm having a three or four category of data, and for simplicity I have only this four characters. And typically, I want to display this actual value in my status. So each for each category, what is the actual sales or what is the actual completion? So this is the planned amount. I mean, this many has to be sold, but this has been sold. So this is what I want to track. It can be used for the KPI as well. So this is the waffle chart I have imported from AppSource. So if you are new to this Power BI, I don't know how to do it. Once you log into your Power BI service, you go and use the get more visuals and you will get a list. I mean, it will take you to the app source and here you start typing waffle chart. So this chart I have downloaded. This is something else. We will talk about it in some other video. Now you click on it and it will be imported in your Power BI file. So let me take this one here, and then you can use this category and values everywhere over here. But first things first, so let me take actual value and put it in values. Once you put this one, it will not give you anything and you see the blank value. So for this chart, the category is important. So once you put this one, you can see the actual value over here, right? 90 40 25 35. It has been splitted across the category. So this waffle chart can be used for many purposes. So you can derive this value for each category and track some percentage of completion with a single column alone, meaning like you have this category and actual value and then you display it. But you do not want to do that. You want to do it as goal and KPI kind of thing, and you can set the maximum value. So that is the planned. When you drag and drop the planned value, now you see it, the percentage changes. Let us go to data. Let us take the bike example, which is the simplest example. The bike, the planned sales should be 80 and the actual is 40, which is 50% of it. So that is what it is showing. When you remove the planned, it will show the actual value as a percentage. Whatever value you are showing here, that actual value, right, for the bike 40 is showing exactly here. Okay, that is the main difference. So once you have you want to track the planned and actual with percentage completion, you can use this waffle chart. So this kind of charts, it's you will give a different look to your Power BI reports. That's why I'm recommending this. People are bored with some conventional reporting or KPI, viewing the KPIs in KH or by chart or bar charts. Then they can look up this option. Let me walk you through other options available. That is what I want to highlight now. Now you do not like this kind of this particular shapes, right? So for that you can go to this path, like you can set up this path. Okay, I will share the link in the description where you can find what is this path indicates. I will share the link in the description, which is the path, which is nothing but SVG file. I mean SVG script. Okay, this script will enable you to create different shapes. You can see this is one kind of shape and this is another kind of shapes, right? So this will give you another look as well. So this is the path. Path is nothing but your shapes for this. And one last thing to highlight here is like you can set the minimum value field, optional field, and what it does. See that when you add, you can see the bike turn to 43%. What it means? So what it does is like this value will be subtracted from your planned and actual, and from there it will calculate. That is, this will become 70 and this will become 30. So what is the percentage distribution of 30 for 70? Let us try to do the calculation. So 30 divided by 70 will equal to 428. That is 43%. That is what it is appearing here. So this is what a minimum value. Most of the times this won't be useful. In some business scenarios they want to ignore certain part from that. So in that cases you can use it. So it is not straightforward whatever minimum value or maximum value you need to use as such is provided. Whichever is the mandatory field you can use it. Other things are optional, and based on your business needs you can customize this. That is what I want to make it here. I hope you like this video. If you like it, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.